a reminder, that's Aaron, and I'm Jamie.
That is my name.
Alright, so pop turns and pop turn variations.
So, you have the videos for the standard pop turn, so we'll get right into the actual variations. The first one we worked on was what we call the yo-yo pop turn yo-yo. So we start with standard pop turn. Turn, triple, catch, connect. The biggest things to remember there is from that pop turn, we're going to trace around the follows back, and then intentionally lead down the line. Rock, step. And then finish it off just as you do with the Lindy circle.
For the followers, really it's getting a good solid connection with our leader, trying not to anticipate what our leader wants to do. From that solid connection, you should be able to feel an intentional rock step and then a triple down the line.
From there, we worked on modifying the standard pop turn. So what we did is from the standard one, we're just bringing a follow down the line. With this one, we're tracing a circle as we make that turn. So it's going to be a looser pop turn, allowing the follow to not travel as far as we would normally.
And we had to clarify earlier that when Aaron says tracing the circle, he's actually meaning using his elbow to trace a circle. Almost like he's stirring the cauldron, actually.
Double, double, 20.
There we go. Okay.
Right.
Wow, that may be good for next time.
All right. Yeah, so pretty much what Jamie said. So from there, we're tracing, okay, with our elbows, loosening it out.
Okay.
And then that's going to allow our follow to not travel as far, allowing us to do a lot more because we won't have to worry about catching to start our other motion.
So that's really, I feel in this connection with that more circular connection, some of the momentum and energy that's usually pent up is being utilized, which is great because that's allowing me not to turn in that direction. It's allowing me to turn right in front of me and Aaron so that we're squared by the end. So that's the goal of this one, is to get us more square. Alright, so once we get square, we can more easily do the pop turn into the swing out. Exit.
For that same kind of circular pop turn, pop turn, you're making that same tracing, but rather than directing back like we did for the yo-yo, we're going to follow this motion and then just bring the follow completely through these.
Okay.
So we're ending it just as we would end any other swing out.
And we also remember had a lot of conversation in this class that here, when we connect on our floor, we are going on an opposite side of our body, the leader's body, than we're used to. Followers, our leaders are giving us a direction straight. We take a step and we go, they get out of our way. Okay, keep our heads up, step, step, triple step. If there's an accident, somebody will adjust.
And lastly, we worked on grapevines. We worked on grapevine variation.
Okay. So you remember we did the drill. We won't do that. You guys can do the drill on your own. But for the pop turn?
So the circular pop turn. From that catch, the biggest difference here, again, leads, is intention. So rather than forward, rather than just going through, we're going to limit the amount of possibilities that the follow can have by just turning in. That's gonna start that grapevine. And as long as we're square with each other. As long as we're square with each other, then that motion can carry through easily.
Alright, so we'll do it from the top. Sorry, go ahead. One, two, three, and four, five, six, five, six, five, six, five, six, five, six, seven, and eight.
So you're just pivoting it around in a circle. However you want to do that, you can grapevine and go for it. If you can't, then just step. Just allow your follow to make those movements.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Cool.